bicycle, if they like to go hiking, if they like to go to a movie, if they like to enjoy going on picnics, that this is life and the way God wants life to be. And the love relationships make that come more alive. And that God and Christianity and church is that community, not these religious things we talk about, but reality.
We haven't left our society anywhere. I mean, everything, TV, the gut dudes on the moon, I mean, everything that society represents is represented here.
True.
And we've all brought that with us. And, I mean, shoot, we sit around and sing Alka-Seltzer commercials. But it's a relationship. It's not just bringing ourselves here because it's a fairy kingdom or anything like that. This is... At times, this can be more real than society as click, click, the city, the bus, the cars. I mean, sure, there's pollution and all that, and sure, we have beautiful stuff here, but God gave us this. He gave us this. This is as real as anything in our society nowadays. It's something that we have to consider.
Yeah, Grandfather's pretty real. Grandfather Mountain and sugar.
Look at the skyline. Yeah, and right above it, you see a big bushy eyebrow, to the left is eyebrow, and then to the right of it is his mouth and beard.
Is yours tight? I'm tightening right now. Hey, Laura?
Yeah?
Jump up in that. Oh, come on. John? Whoa, man. How we just figure out which one of these things is leaking?
Well, the one is near the lake.
Wait. That's that one. That one is.
Where's the brush one?
Right here. That one.
I'm right behind you.
Go.
I know
I'm at least like 2 or 3 miles. Thank you, babe. Kim, you want to run? Yeah,
it's probably turquoise.
Yeah, but how many rings she got? She's got 4 rings.
She has on
What about your outdoor activities? What about hiking? What's your favorite? What's your favorite trail?
Grandfather Mountain.
Wilderness.
Piggyback Hill.
That's great. How many of you enjoyed Roan Mountain the most? That's your favorite trail?
No.
Three.
Three.
All right, how many for Grandfather Mountain? Grandfather Mountain, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, Sugar Mountain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Oh, far and above. Sugar Mountain is the favorite mountain.
What about Wilderness?
What thought sticks out in your mind from any of the things that we've talked about this week? Can you quote a proverb for me? Pull one for us.
He meddles in a quarrel not his own. He's like one that gets ever passing dog by the knee.
I'm going to get out of the proverbs, although the proverbs have, there's a number of proverbs that say this. But we're going to use the first psalm tonight, Psalm 1, which has the secret of being able to prosper in everything that we do. And here's what the first psalm says. It starts off, blessed, which means happy. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. I want to give you a challenge as you go home, because this is something you can take with you and really use. And that is to find some time every day, and I would suggest starting with 5 minutes. Take 5 minutes and plan that every day at a certain time for 5 minutes, you'll spend some time reading and studying your Bible. That's the greatest challenge I could give to you.
So it is a laboratory. We do have a laboratory in which to experiment and try to bring the Christian reality or God's love to bear on how it ought to be in relationships.
And what we hope, that the final hope is that the kids and we ourselves will leave here and be able to take the laboratory experiment and apply it outside.
Good to see you again, too. All right. Farewell.
Come back. Yeah, we will.
Don't worry, we are going to come
back. Hey, that means y'all can't go.
I feel that they learn things. I feel that some kids, I'm not saying everybody, but I'm saying that some kids feel a love, and it may not change their whole life, but at least they're aware of it. It brings a new awareness to them of this aspect of society. And
it's like you might go the whole week and a kid would never pick up on anything that you did the whole week. So he leaves and you say goodbye to him and say, "Well, I'm really glad you came this week. Please come back."
Bye.
Yes, please, Louise.
I'm going.
Bye, Bye. Bye.
Well, shall we evaluate?
We've just got Jonathan, and we can come out when we get to him.
Yeah, let's go ahead and do it.
Bye!
We'll see y'all later.
Bye! Bye! You come get me when you're comfortable.